All right, let's jump right in. The 7 things that you can work on that'll take your modeling game to the next level. Tip number 1, back to basics, it's gonna be your setup. If you aren't already, you're gonna wanna get used to using one hand to navigate and select objects and the other hand to enter commands. We also wanna maximize our screen real estate, give us enough space so we can see what we're doing, find where we're going, select what we need to select, do all the things we need to do in modeling space. Have you ever watched a photographer or a videographer edit at all? Those screens that they work on are really big, right? Why? They need space to see what they're doing and to work effectively. It's the same for us. But even on your existing screen, you can maximize the space that's allocated for modeling and make everything more efficient. And with the interface, try using it as is as first, but as you become more comfortable, start customizing it and tweaking it to better suit the ways that you tend to work. Tip number 2, learn to fly. Navigation is huge in any 3D software. Pan, orbit, zoom, these are the basic navigation functions, but learn the zoom command, learn how to get in and out of areas in your model quickly, learn how to isolate what it is that you want to work on so you're not seeing a bunch of other distracting stuff while you're trying to work on something small. Learn different ways to navigate too. Sometimes you really need that kind of big view where you can see the whole model, and sometimes you really just need to get in and walk through your model as though you're at eye level. So tip number 3 is gonna be selection. Being able to select things quickly, accurately, and efficiently is the gateway to all modeling. Almost every single command I run is gonna require me to select something either first or after I run the command. Learn as many ways to select and deselect objects as you possibly can. Window and crossing selections, the selection commands, the selection filters, locking and unlocking objects. Each of these things are like individual tools in your toolkit. They each have a specific place in your workflow, and you can break them out at different times to get different things done. All right, so number 4, model organization.
Keeping it tight.
Layers are your friend. They are the primary means for organizing a huge amount of data. Display color, line weight, line type, selection, visibility, material, the list goes on. And you can control all the individual combinations of these properties through something called layer states. We'll look into that in a future video. So one really basic thing is just model near the origin, the 000 world coordinate. There's a lot of times I see people who have models way out in space somewhere, and there's no need to do this unless you have a very specific reason. When you import things from other libraries into these models, they usually come in near the origin anyway. This way you won't have to go fishing to find that thing that you just imported. Duplicates, duplicates. Don't do them. Don't do them. They just get in the way.
Sounds good. Sounds good.
I see a lot of people who have a lot of extra geometry in their models, and it just makes everything harder because you're selecting things and getting a selection menu that pops up and you need to deal with that, and there's no need. Just don't create duplicate geometry unless there's a really, really good reason. There's usually not. As our models increase in complexity, we need to learn how to manage that complexity. Tools like blocks and groups can help us out with that. Check this video out to learn more. All right, so on to tip number 5. Precision. So the famed basketball coach John Wooden has a saying that I really like. Be quick, but don't hurry. And this is totally applicable to 3D modeling. We want to move as quickly as we possibly can, but we don't want that quickness to come at the sacrifice of the quality of our model. Think about spending as much time on the organization of your model as the modeling itself. In the end, this totally pays off. A well-built digital model won't fight you every step of the way, and you'll be able to move through the later stages of everything much, much faster. So tip number 6 is the interconnectedness of all these other ideas. When we start seeing these things as not individual issues kind of living in a vacuum, you start to see how selection becomes easier if my model is organized properly, or how my navigation speeds up if I have like my hands set up in the right place on the keyboard and mouse. These things don't function in isolation. They all relate to one another, and if you can put these other ideas into play together, you'll find everything just becomes so much smoother and easier. All right, and the final one, tip number 7, is begin with the end in mind. And I'm not quite sure whose quote that is, but I think it's really applicable to our work here. It's a little more abstract than some of the others because it's not dealing specifically with something about the software, but just follow along for a second. So, as someone who is often helping someone else who's actively working on something, I often find that if I just ask them to stop and to verbalize the best way that they can think of to do something, they're much more able to do so than as they're working on it and doing it. If we can take a step back from what we're, you know, just immediately working on, often much more efficient, much smarter and faster solutions become clearer. You probably have many of these skills already, the ones I've talked about. It's a matter of having awareness in the moment to put them into place. So as you're working, as you're encountering these individual challenges, take a step back for a second and just think about the best way to do something. Sometimes waiting a second is the best use of your time. Also, this lets us pause and think about, hey, maybe there is a better way to do something. If I spend a minute or two trying to find a different way than the one that comes to mind for how to do something, maybe I'll learn something that pays off long-term for like hours of my time rather than I just know this way to do it, so I'm just gonna kind of power through it right now. Well, that about wraps it up. This has been a pretty good summary of the information I would want to share with someone who I was working with on their 3D skills. And a lot of the information can at first seem a little bit generic, right? Like we didn't even get into the software at all. And that's kind of the point. It's not platform specific. It doesn't matter what software you're using, whether you're using SketchUp or 3ds Max or Maya or Cinema 4D or any of these programs, it doesn't matter. Concepts like navigation, object selection, model organization, all of these things still apply. The exact mechanisms that are used in each of those softwares might differ slightly, but really when it comes down to it, it's about developing these fundamental skills. Whether you're a beginner, an intermediate, or an advanced modeler, I think you can really benefit from focusing in on these key issues, continuing to improve them, and just generally making yourself a more adept 3D modeler. So no matter what level of experience you may have, or where you are on your own personal modeling journey, I hope that you're able to take some of these ideas and concepts and apply them to your next project. And if you have any questions about any of the concepts that I introduced or about their application, go ahead and post them in the comments. And as always, if you found this video helpful, give me a thumbs up and subscribe below if you'd like to see more videos like it in the future. And if you have a friend or a coworker who you think would find this video helpful too, do me and them a favor and share the channel with them. Thanks guys, and happy modeling. My brain is melting.